Hi, in this video, we will track how this lesson list is set up. So again, on the post type, when we created this custom post type, we have enabled the archive. That's why we're able to call that archive here. So that's this log. This is my website URL, and then this is the slug of this archive, and it has listed the post that is inside this post type. So that's this is our archive. So if we open this in Elementor, we have an archive. I'm going to open that in a new tab. In here, we have a title, which we manually type in. We have some text, and we have exactly similar query result count that we were using on the dashboard. If you haven't watched the previous video where I've showed you how I've exactly set this up, please go back to the dashboard setup page tutorials first. It will show you exactly how this has been set up. But we're using exactly the same. So we can even save this as a global widget if we want. But in our example here, I haven't done that. But you can, so that you can just control the design in one place. Next is we have the listing grid from JetEngine. And as you can see, it's pulling the intro list, and then it has this query, so total lessons. So we're still using the total lessons query that we are also using in this one. So if we check, let's open that listing so that it will make more sense. So I'm gonna go to JetEngine listing, but you can also access this listing from here. It will show, so you can just click that or open that in a new tab, and it will point you to that listing. Or you can go to the JetEngine and search that list, which is, in my case, it's this one. And when I edit that, it will open exactly similar to this one. I'm just gonna close this so that I can focus on this screen. Okay, so I have here, I'm just going to limit my preview width. Okay, so we have this design, and we have the post title. We have dynamic field, which is colored and grayed, just like the achievement list that we have on the dashboard. And then we have two buttons. This is, I think, this is the colored. And then this is button. And then this is, let me just zoom in. This is the gray button. Again, we can confirm that by turning on and off. So as you can see, we have the gray button enabled because the eye icon is colored blue, which means that's enabled. So I can see the gray icon, and if I turn that off, it's now gone. And if I click the colored button, it's showing. So that's another way of checking which widget are you in. So we have that. Now let's check what rules or dynamic visibility rules that we have set up. So we have, for the colored button under dynamic visibility, we have show element if conditions meet. Post ID is, and we're using the related items, and it is using the relation intro completed item, so the one that we have set up, and then child object, current user ID. And then for the gray button, so it's just vice versa. So rather than post ID is, we're using post ID is not, and it should be exactly similar to the colored button that we have. The only difference is this one, post ID is not. So that's for the button. Now for the icons, it should be also similar because what I did is I want to show colored when the login students has completed that lessons, and it's gonna go be showing the gray if they haven't completed that lesson yet. So again, just a recap, I'm gonna remove one of the lessons from my progress. So I'm gonna do disconnect, and then if I refresh here, so now this is great because it is not part of my completed lessons, and that's also showing grade icon, the check button, and so on. If I visit that, so it's gonna show me with this mark complete button rather than the complete one. I think it was cache that showed earlier, so when changing settings like this, especially if you think it will affect your members' view, make sure to clear your cache so to prevent that kind of message, even if it got fixed when I reloaded it. So again, on the colored timer, we have exactly similar rule from the colored button. And of course, for the gray timer, we have exactly similar rule for the gray button. So you just need to copy that. And we added some styling so that it aligns like this. Now on the listing, we have created the query total lessons. Again, it's exactly similar to what we have in here. So we don't need to create another one when we built this archive page. So that's it for this archive page and the listing. I'll see you in the next video.